Hello, I'm Chris Menard. In today's Excel video, we're going to take a look at the home interest rates for a 30-year loan, how it's gone from roughly 2.85% last year in 2021 to almost 5.9% in July of 2022, and what that does to your payment for your principal and interest. We'll look at a house at $400,000, which is now the median price of a new home in the United States, and we'll also bump it up just a tad. I'm going to do at least three Excel functions. I'm also going to use the scenario manager in Excel. If I had to classify this video, I would call it Excel Advanced because we're using a lot of stuff in one video. The file will be available for you to download on my website. Also, this is a great exercise if you're an accounting student, a business student, or if you're in the market for a new home or a refi. So just to show you where I'm getting my data from before we dive in, I'm on Nerd Wallet's website. I am not affiliated with them at all, but here is June 30, 2022, 30-year loan, and here is a 15-year loan. Notice on the 29th, it was 5.78, 5.831. Interest rates do change all the time. I'm going to scroll down. And here we are now in the April, May, and June of 2021. So just a year ago, you can see they're 2.79, 2.832. So this is where I'm getting my data from. Also, the median price, as I mentioned, in the U.S. is over $400,000 now. Here is the Atlanta market where I live, $412,000 for the median home price. Let's pop up Excel and dive into this, and feel free to check the bookmarks down below. So I have Excel running right now. Zoom in just a tad. Here we go. 2.875, 30 years, $400,000. I'll end up creating four different scenarios for this, and then we'll look at them all at one time. Let's run through some of these Excel functions first. The payment function, I've done this a million times, but here you go. The interest rate divided by 12, comma, 30 years, 12 months in a year, comma, negative, whatever the loan amount is. This is the amount of money you're borrowing, so I'm assuming right here that this is after a down payment. I made it negative B3, 1660 is your monthly payment for your principal and interest. That does not include taxes, insurance, if you have a HOA fee, if you have to pay private mortgage insurance, PMI, it does not include that. That's just the principal and interest right there. That was an Excel function because I used PMT. Here's a formula. That amount, 30 years times 12. That is the total payments we'll make over 30 years. How much interest we're going to pay? Another formula. That 597 minus 400,000. So I'm going to pay 197,000 in interest. Two really cool Excel functions. Both are very similar. I want to find out what's going to be the cumulative interest paid from month one to month 36, so the first 3 years, how much interest do I pay? Then I want to find out how much principal I pay for the first 3 years. If you're looking, though, for month year four to year six, it's going to be 37,72. Let's jump into this right now. So there is equals cumulative interest payment. If you look down at the definition, it's going to be between the start period and the end period. Everything works the same, divided by 12. Let me just quickly put this in here. 30 times 12. This time though, you don't put in a negative, B3. Period one, period 36, one through 36 is the first 3 years. And just do a zero, make it the end of the period. I'm gonna pay $33,412 in interest the first 3 years. It showed as a negative. I'm going to just add a negative at the very beginning of this. There you go. I'm in cell B10. I don't want to have to retype that whole thing because I'm going to reference the same cells. Control and an apostrophe copies it down exactly. cumulative principal, and there's the definition again between two periods. That's exactly what I want. Perfect. And again, double click, make it a negative because I know I'm paying it. Real quick check figure for you though. If I take 1660 times 36, that's 12 times 3 years, 59,745. Those two equal 59,745. There we go. All right. Let's get rid of these two empty rows. I was going to do something exciting, but I'm just going to hold off on that and delete them. There you go. So if you notice the first three cells, B1, B2, and B3, I just typed them in. Those are input cells. All the other cells are dependent cells. They've got a formula or a function in them. There you go. So you can see them right there. You don't have to do this step. We're headed to the scenario manager right now. You don't have to do this step, but I like to name the range. So highlight them, go to the formulas tab at the top, create from selection. I've got A1 to cell B8 selected. Left column is correct. Hit OK in case you're wondering what in the world happened. I'm in cell D1 right now. Look over to the far left. In the name box, it says D1. But when I click on B1, it doesn't say B1. It says interest rate. If I go down to loan amount and click it, it does. So I named those cells is all it did. Not required again, but I just like to do that. Highlight your input cells. I only have three and they happen to be together. Go to the data tab. What if analysis, scenario manager. Add, okay, this is lower rate and lower loan amount. I'm making this up. Changing is always going to be your input. It even says that right here. Non-adjacent sales, your input sales, changing sales. Click OK. Perfect. Don't change anything. This is my original data. So now I'm going to add. So now higher interest rate and lower loan amount. Hit OK. All that's changing in this example is there is my 2.875. I am going to change that to, remember the interest rates are now almost 5.9%. I'm just going to make it 0.059. Add. Now I'm thinking about getting a lower rate and higher home loan. I'm thinking about doing a $550,000 loan. Hit OK. We're still at 2.875. We're still going for 30 years. $550,000. Add. Last one. Higher rate and higher loan amount. Hit OK. What were we doing? 0.059550000. There we go. So there you go. There are your four scenarios. Now, and I hit OK this time, by the way, and they pulled up. In case you're wondering, someone may say to me later, Chris, couldn't you have just copied the data in column B and pasted it in columns C, D, and E, and that would have been all four of them, and then even put a label above them? The answer is yes, I could have. But there is something I like about the scenario manager when someone says, show me this rate. Lower rate and lower loan amounts right here. I just double click on it, or I can click on it and hit show. But I'm gonna just double click. Watch this. There's your 5.9. Notice your payment is 2373. I'm gonna double click on the top one again. 1660 versus 2373. How about that? So here we go now with the third and fourth one. This is where the house went up to 550,000. There's the 2.875, 2282, 3262. That's a huge difference just from the interest rate going up. By the way, all the other numbers are changing also. I should have pointed that out. If you notice, total payments is $874,000 at the 5.9 for $400,000, and they're $597,000 at 2.875. So 597 to 584. What's cool about the scenario manager is you can hit close. You need to pull it up again. You just go to scenario manager and there it is. If you want to put them all on one sheet, which is what someone is probably going to suggest I did to begin with, I can do this from here. I just go hit summary. And this time you actually want to highlight all the dependent cells, which are your formulas and your functions. So when you create the scenario manager, you select the input cells. And then when you want to put them all together, you select the dependent cells. When I hit OK, I'm going to get a new worksheet at the bottom of my screen, and there'll be five columns, and I'll show you why there's five. Perfect. It always pulls in whatever current value you are working on. I usually just right click and delete this one. So there you go with my names in here. You can see why I named it, or else it would have said B1, B2, B3, B4, B5, B6. That's why I name them, so I can see what they are. And I can sit here and compare them, and you can still do formulas over here if you wanted to. Really, really cool feature. We did a lot of stuff in here. Let me know if you like this video. Feel free to subscribe, ring the bell. Thank you for your time.